If you don't understand the language of God, you will be going right when he's calling you to left. And that is what is happening in our day. The Bible says, and Jesus was with quick understanding. It's not enough to work miracles. Do you understand why you are working it? It's not enough to receive a breakthrough. Do you understand why the breakthrough came? Are you quick to remember to consult God before you make decisions, before you judge? Who are the people you have cast out that you didn't consult the fear of the Lord around it? Who dare you condemn who God has justified? But we don't understand. We are so slow to understanding. So we condemn those God have justified. We attack those God has blessed. We curse those God have lifted because we are not of quick understanding. Oh, make me a man of quick understanding. And when this spirit comes, you will go back and apologize to the people you attack. When this spirit comes, you will go back and work things right. When this spirit comes upon you, quick understanding. It's not enough to have the spirit of knowledge. You need quick understanding into the spirit of knowledge. It's not enough to even have the spirit of the fear of God. You need a quick understanding. Ah, God, make me sharp. Let me understand. If you don't have this spirit, you will stay in church and still fornicate because you are not quick to understand that this thing is a defilement to your soul. The reason why we hear so many preachings and yet nothing is changing about our lives is this aspect of our lives. Quick understanding into the fear of God. Whenever you are being tempted to fornicate, do you remember you must fear God? Wherever you are confronted with temptations to give up on the faith, do you remember that you must stand for God and fear God? Whenever the opportunity comes to sin, do you remember that you must fear God? That was the uniqueness of Jesus' ministry. Quick understanding. When you are walking with Jesus, he does not operate by what this eye sees, and he does not operate by what this ear. So you call Jesus and tell him that, Jesus, I heard this and that about you. That is fine, but there is another anointing operating in him. The Bible calls it quick understanding in the fear of the Lord. So he may have all kinds of dealings with people, but the Bible says never would Jesus judge by the things he sees with his eyes. So you and Jesus will see somebody drunk, but before Jesus will judge the matter, there is something more that influences before he judges the matter. You and Jesus will meet somebody fornicating, and you will take a stone and begin to stone the woman. But when Jesus comes around, there is another thing working in him. The Bible calls it the spirit of quick understanding in the fear of the Lord. So when we are handling matters, we handle it with quick emotions. But when Jesus comes, he handles it with quick understanding in the fear. In other words, before he does anything, he checks and analyzes the fear of God around it. What does God think about this? How does God see this? How does God, what is God's intention about it? That was how Jesus was operating. The Bible says that on top of his seven anointings were this special one. Most of us, it's taking us a long time to understand. You may understand, but sometimes you understand 40 years time, and by that time you have wasted a lot of years. The Bible says the man was with quick understanding. So he would tell them that, the Bible will record of him that, for Jesus knowing what to do, the man was with quick understanding. You bring a matter before him and he understands what to do. He doesn't tell you go and come in 3 days time. Quick understanding in the fear of the Lord. He didn't forget his fear for God in matters. Many of us, when we get angry, we easily forget that we fear God. When issues come before us, we easily forget. Bible says that the precious gift that was given to Jesus was that he was quick in understanding. Some of us have messed up. We have lost beautiful and powerful blessings because we didn't have this thing called quick understanding. Luke chapter 24 tells us that it's possible to experience slow understanding. There were two men walking in the road of Emmaus, and Jesus began to speak to them, and they never saw that this is Jesus. And they were asking about Jesus, confused. Can Jesus rise up again? They are saying on the third day, Jesus has rose up. And Jesus said, you people, oh fools, you people are slow understanding. There is a grace for quick understanding, and there is another thing called slow understanding. Woe unto you if you are slow in understanding. The Bible says that a man in honor that understandeth not is like a beast that perish. in the forest. You are already into doom if you don't understand why you are man. You are already in doom if you don't understand why you are in Grace Mountain. You are already in doom if you don't understand why you are saved. You are already doomed if you don't understand why Jesus came. The whole architect of destiny is understanding. And the Bible says God gifted Jesus with quick standing. God can come and visit you without understanding, you will miss him. The Bible talks of how Peter encountered God. And a basket came full of animals. God said, kill and eat. Peter said, I don't eat corrupt and defiled things. God said, kill it and eat. He said, I don't eat it. And God said, why do you make something that is extraordinary common? Why are you calling this common? It's not common. It has been sanctified. It's not common. But the man was slow to understand it. How far and how long will you wait for what God is trying to teach you? The church is lingering back because we don't have understanding into the ways of God. So there is a Holy Spirit teaching, but men don't understand. There are signals in heaven telling us that Jesus is coming very soon, but the church don't understand. There were times that he was tempted. This is a man that is fasting, very hungry, and then their body comes to test him of the power that he carries. Read Psalm 63, you will see what the experience of the prayer of Jesus in the wilderness. The Bible speaks of the kind of prayer. It said, let me see your power as it is in the sanctuary. So in the wilderness of Jordan, it was told that Jesus was praying about power. It was David that showed us. He said that my soul thirsts for water in a dry and thirsty place, that I will see the power of God as it is in the sanctuary. And he was prophesying about Jesus' fasting experience. That means Jesus has prayed 40 days, 40 nights, crying for power. And then the temptation comes that can you turn this stone to bread? And then the man with quick understanding knew, I have received power, but it's not everywhere I'll demonstrate the power. How much of understanding do you have in operating the gift that God has given you? The opportunities God has given you, how we have missed serving the devil with the blessings God has given us because we don't have quick understanding. Many of us have promoted the kingdom of darkness with the very blessing that God has given us because we don't have understanding. Some of you, yes, I believe that you will understand later, but that later you would have destroyed many destinies. Some of you, with your slowness in understanding, souls are going to hell. Because you should have preached to them. You didn't, because all this while, you don't understand the essence of soul winning. So you have been hearing it, but because you don't understand, souls are passing by and going to hell because you don't understand. Most of us have caused many to backslide from the faith because we don't understand our place in love for them. So we are used to the flesh. We consult our emotions and we make decisions and we don't understand that it is a detriment to our future and the future of others. This is a prayer you must pray from the depth of your heart. Make me of quick understanding. The day you get this understanding, if you are David, you will see Saul sleeping and you still not kill him, because you know that if you kill him, you have defiled the oil on the throne and you will never sit on that throne. Some of you, if the spirit of quick understanding hit your life, a major decision you are taking right now, you will just reverse it because you know that this thing will destroy you. Jesus tells them that I will be dying very soon, but on the third day, I will rise up. The Bible says that, and Peter pulled him aside and started to reprimand him and tell him that, Lord, let this be far from you. And then this is Jesus' response to tell, he said that, get thee away from me, Satan. And then he describes Satan and he says that, you are a dangerous trap to me. You are seeing things merely from a human point of view, not from God's. That means Satan looks like human's point of view. So anytime you are operating from your carnal mind, you look like Satan. You look like Satan. Anytime a man refuses to operate by the understanding into the way God sees things, you are like Satan. You are not different. Satan is not anywhere. He's a human mindset.
My God.
He's the way people think, far from the way God thinks.
Yes,
and
Jesus
turns back. This is Jesus speaking. He turns back and calls a human being Satan and tells him, why I'm calling you Satan? Because you are seeing things from merely human point of view. So Apostle Paul will pray for the church of Ephesus and said that your eyes of your understanding will be opened. Will be open. Without it, you will be wasting time in church. That the eyes of your understanding will be open. And that you will know the the hope of your calling. It's not enough for Jesus to save you. You must understand why he has saved you. That you will know the glory of the inheritance and the power that is available to you. Somebody must understand it. It takes quick understanding for a man like Joseph to miss an opportunity with Potiphar's wife. The reason why we are running into trouble and in sin, the difference is quick understanding. What came into Joseph's mind to have to run away and not talk, not complain, not fight, even when he was charged into prison? There was something at work in him. What touched the heart of the three Hebrew men that they all spoke the same language? Even if our God will not save us, we won't bow. How can three people see things the same way? The spirit of quick understanding. They were ready. Three people. Sometimes when three people meet, at least two share the same mind. One was, but this time three, they were all ready to enter. Why? Because a quick understanding was at work in them. We know our God, even at the face of danger, we know him. And many of us have given up on our faith because of poverty. We don't understand that sometimes poverty leads to riches. The reason why we are giving up and we are getting worried is that we don't know that it is through pain that glory is born. Jesus said, how are you so slow to heart and to understand it? Don't you know that the Christ must suffer and then be glorified? Quick understanding in the fear of God means that to make decisions of God, to make decisions in line with God, to take directions in line with God, quick understanding in the fear of God. Don't wait to fall before you understand. Don't wait to be disgraced before you understand. Don't wait to lose your spiritual gifts before you understand. Don't wait to lose your marriage before you understand. Don't wait to lose a breakthrough before you understand. Lord, make me of quick understanding. Quick understanding. Jacob says, so God was here, and I did not know. Don't wait for him to go before you understand. Don't wait for 2021 to pass before you understand that there was an assignment for you in 2021. Don't wait for people to leave you before you understand that God sent them. Don't wait to lose a blessing before you understand that that blessing was on assignment. I pray everybody here, may your eyes be open. Amen. The eyes of your understanding be open. Amen. I said, may the eyes of your understanding be open.
Amen.
With God, the valley is the way to the mountaintop. But sometimes we don't understand, so we give up in the valley. David said, though I walk in the valley of the shadow of death, I will not fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. A man with quick understanding. Can you understand why you are going through the problem you are going through? Can you understand why that rejection came? Can you understand why that disappointment came? God never messes up. God, everything God is doing, the Bible says that it is right and it is good. The problem is that men don't understand. The Bible says that because you do not understand, the whole earth is out of order. Our lives are out of order. Psalm 82, because we don't understand. Our lives are not in shape because we don't understand. Anything that is not of God is Satan. And the greatest blessing and gift you can receive is to have a quick understanding into the fear of God. Without understanding, prophecy will come, but it will mean nothing to your destiny. The key to assessing the glory of God is understanding. Jesus received seven spirits and God topped it up with the eight. Quick understanding. It's not even enough to have the spirit of the fear of God. You must have the quick understanding into the fear of God. If that spirit comes, church will be different. It's high time we understand the power in giving quickly before we waste many years.
Jesus.
You have to pray, God, give me quick understanding. Let me understand honor quickly before I waste many years of my life. Let me understand holiness quickly before I waste many years. I need quick understanding into faithfulness in the work of God. I need it before I waste 10 years of my ministry. Quick understanding. Give me quick understanding into why I am a wife and a husband before I waste my marriage life. When you are attacked with slow understanding, that is when you live a life of regret. After 15 years, you turn back and realize that if I had done it this way and that way and that way, things would have been different. But you see what? You have already been attacked with slow understanding. There is a way to prosper. There is a way to be favored. There is a way to be promoted in this kingdom. That way is the highway of understanding. Never think that in this season, God is not lifting people. He's lifting mighty people. Yes, but sir. It's people who understand his ways.
Sir. Yes, sir.
He's
yes, sir.
Lifting. He's blessing. He's elevating. He's empowering. God is always at work. But he works for those who understand. Judas was seated on the table. Jesus said that the one that will betray me, even if we put a stone on his neck and put him in the sea, it's better for him. Yet, the man went and betrayed him. It's not enough to hear powerful preachings. You must understand. Clearly, the man heard the warning, but the truth is that he didn't understand. One day we will get to heaven and we realize that all the circumstances of our life were shown us in dreams. We only didn't understand. There are times that the wind that is blowing around you is carrying a message. You just don't understand. If you see Moses carrying a rod, it is not a normal rod. It's a snake. It can turn into a snake. It can part Red Sea into two. You just don't understand to mess with that. The people that complain and blame and say everybody is wrong, by the time you check their lives, they are suffering from lack of understanding. When that spirit hits you, when you are slow to heart, you will condemn everybody until the day your eyes open. That is where you tell yourself, I have been wrong. Many of us have judged pastors, but we don't know that they are operating high above our understanding now. Many of us have judged our parents, but we don't know they were operating high above our understanding now. If your understanding is not up to people and they are very high from you, the next thing you give them is complaints and attack. So secretly, you gather two or three people and you begin to point to them to let them feel that the leader is wrong, but you don't know that you have not gotten there yet. And many of us, by the time we will get there, we would have missed many blessings in life. People can live a life of not understanding God to a point that even if they kill you, they think they are doing God a service. There are people doing things that they think they are serving God, but they are far from serving God because of the lack of understanding. Very far from serving God. He said they will kill you thinking they are doing God a service. He said, did we not prophesy in your name? He said, get away, I knew you not. Did we not work signs and wonders? He said, get away, I knew you not. Ye that did not the will of my Father. There is a way that you can busy yourself for God, but finally he will tell you, I don't know you, because you didn't understand the will of God concerning the thing that you were doing. The Bible said that one time Paul told the church of Romans, he said that you have zeal without knowledge. It's possible to be doing things outside of God's intention. And he said that you know of the righteousness that is of men, but you don't know the righteousness that is of God. So there is a way you can be doing something, it looks like it is of God, but it is not. And that is the experience of most of us as Christians. It is on the day of judgment that we realize that we wasted our time. Most of us, it is on the day of judgment that our disappointment will be so clear to us. So all this while, this was not what God really wanted for me. That is when you will appreciate today's prayer, that God will give you quick understanding. Amen. Into the fear of the Lord. That Amen. You will not operate by what these eyes see, and you will not operate by what these ears hear. That is why many demons have had access to the pulpit and they call themselves pastors, because the church is not of quick understanding. We only operate by sight and we operate by what we hear. But he said that the Bible says, and Jesus did not judge by what this I see. I pray in the name of Jesus, from today you will operate with your friends from the spirit of quick understanding. You will do business with quick understanding. You will marry with quick understanding. You will have fellowship with quick understanding. You will come to church with quick understanding. In the name of Jesus, clap your hands and shout, I'm anointed to understand quickly. In the name of Jesus.